The question whether there should be a mandatory age for Supreme Court justices actually goes back to the beginning of the Supreme Court. In the earliest days of the Constitution, when the Federalists and the Anti-Federalists were arguing about what the Supreme Court should look like and what that would mean, this is an issue that Hamilton, writing as Publius in the Federalists, specifically considered. At that time, New York required judges to retire at age 60, and Hamilton made it clear that he thought 60 was too young. He said, there's really no problem because so few outlive the season of intellectual vigor. So he did not think that you needed to be concerned about that. And the other thing that he brought up was, in a country where few are wealthy and pensions are unreliable, it was really inhumane to put people out of a job when they were unlikely to be able to find another one that would keep body and soul together. And he dismissed what he said was the imaginary danger of a superannuated bench. And perhaps he was so certain about that because lifespans then were considerably shorter. There's always been concern about judges becoming mentally incapacitated, unable to serve, and a number of chief justices going all the way back to the 1700s have thought that one way to solve this problem would be to have a mandatory age for retirement, perhaps 70, perhaps 75, or something like that.